What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Freezing My B**s Off with Geo. Today we're going to be discussing the Contax G2. Is it a rangefinder or a point and shoot? I'll let you guys decide. Currently, I'm out here on location. I figured I'd switch things up a little bit, make a video as I shoot it instead of making the video after the fact, instead of sitting at home. Not sure if this is a great decision or not. It is currently 26 degrees outside, so it's freezing. So this might have been a really bad idea, might have been a good one. We'll see, can't really tell. Some of you may be wondering, if it's so cold and he's complaining about the temperature, why isn't his beanie covering his ears? Because I like fashion and it looks cool. Easily one of my favorite 35 millimeter cameras. I mean, probably if not the best 35 millimeter camera compared to the Leica M6. Now, I don't know if you can actually compare it to the Leica M6 or not. Maybe you can, maybe you can't. Kind of personal preference. It depends on if you like it, if you don't. A lot of people don't like to call the Contax G2 a rangefinder, and that's because it has an auto mode. That means it auto selects shutter speed and it has an auto focus. The cool thing is, like a rangefinder, you can look through the viewfinder and not through the lens like a typical SLR camera. Now, another reason that's hard is because if you miss autofocus, typically it's going to be the camera's fault and not your fault. Now, if you select it on manual focus and you meter your range, like select your meters for focusing, if you miss a shot, then that's your fault, not necessarily the camera's fault. Now, that was a huge upgrade from the G1. The Contax G1 was said to have terrible autofocus. Now, I've never shot one, but I've seen plenty of reviews that say it was awful. People would miss focus on half of the roll. Now, I've shot quite a few rolls through the G2 so far, and the autofocus is fantastic. It focuses very fast and it's pretty accurate for the most part. When it comes to actually using the autofocus, now don't get it twisted with your new DSLR cameras that have 72 point autofocus, 170 point. Like, this one has typically one center weighted focusing point, which is directly in the center of the lens. There is obviously the trick where you can half press down to focus on your, I guess, subject, and then move your camera to actually compose as you desire. Typically that's hit or miss. I have tried that several times, and I don't know, you can sometimes get a shot, sometimes you don't. The reason people compare this to the Leica M6 is because it has phenomenal glass. Carl Zeiss lenses, to be exact. There are, I want to say, four lenses. There's a 45 millimeter, there's a 35 millimeter, a 90 millimeter, and a 28 millimeter. Oh, and there's also, I think, a 16 millimeter, which is kind of rare, but it's almost like a $2,000 lens, which is really cool. I haven't had the chance to shoot one, but I'm sure I would want to. This does have a titanium built body along with lens caps and filters, and it is phenomenal, the build quality of this camera. The price point is fair as well. I mean, you can get a setup for around $1,200, $1,600, depending on what the lens come with and the condition or whatever, but overall it's a really good price. The downside about that is, if you heard me mention in my previous video when shooting the Contax T2, is that Contax is no longer around, so finding parts to fix a G2 is becoming harder and harder as they go bad. That means that once it goes bad, yet again, you're stuck with a paperweight. You might not, if you can get, I mean, there are still places that do fix them in the US, but there's just not that many of them. You can't take it to any local camera store and get it fixed. That could be a turnoff when it comes to purchasing one. Now, the G2 does have a full manual mode where it has exposure compensation, it has multiple exposures, pretty much everything that a regular manual camera does. It does have a little dial on the top of it, and you use that for focusing. I guess it's the front, not necessarily the top, and that's how you focus manually. That does take a little bit getting used to if you're not used to it at first. I think I did misfocus quite a bit when I was first trying that out, but once you kind of figure out how that works, I mean, it's pretty fabulous how fantastic the camera really is. Another really cool thing about the G2, which I think it's a really cool thing, is that the shutter speed. A lot of 35 millimeter cameras shoot up to 2/1000ths of a second in shutter speed, even slower if you get up to 120 cameras. I mean, me and Format, they shoot maybe 400 at as fast as, I think the Pentax 6.7 shoots 1/1000ths of a second. The Contax G2 35 millimeter camera can shoot 4/1000ths of a second. That is phenomenal with coupling with shooting wide open in the middle of the day. I mean, how many times would you like to shoot at f2 when it's fairly sunny out? I mean, that just makes it that much more attainable and another good selling point, at least in retrospect for me. I mean, I might be a little biased because I don't own an M6, and my god, the price for them are crazy, but considering the price of the Contax G2, I think it's probably the best 35 millimeter camera you can get your hands on. I mean, it's pretty universal, has lens setup where you can use it for almost anything, whether you're shooting weddings, landscapes, portraits, I mean, you name it. Kids, it has fast shutter speed. You can pretty much do whatever you want to with this camera, and that is a bonus. It's one of the biggest things that I like about the camera is just the ease of use of it. It is literally a beginner could grab this camera and start shooting with it and have no issues whatsoever. As long as you obviously understand the basic functions of photography, you would have no problems. Now, I don't know if a beginner would want to spend that much money on a camera right up front, especially considering the fact that, like I said, if you break it, you're pretty much SOL, and that's not good for anybody. Another really cool, like, raving function, to me at least, is not only does it have a single shot mode, but it has a continuous burst mode. Now, a lot of, well, I mean, almost no film cameras have continuous burst mode unless they're, like, fairly new, but this thing shoots particularly fast. You can blow through a roll, I mean, Jesus Christ, within a few minutes, easily, if not faster than that. That's very cool. I mean, I don't know how accurate it would be for shooting like birds and stuff where you need really fast continuous mode, or excuse me, continuous burst, but this shoots pretty fast. And I mean, I don't know if you could ask for better considering the camera was made in, I think, 96, 94, something like that. So it has a timer mode, a multiple exposure, continuous burst, and single shot, which is pretty typical for newer cameras. So for a 35 millimeter camera made in the early 90s, they had to have been ahead of the game when it came to that kind of technology at that time. I did load a roll of Kodak Gold 200, and if you can tell by how gloomy it is out here, it might not be that aesthetically appealing to shoot today, but we'll go from there and see what happens. Not only is it very cold out here, it's also my birthday, so I'm shooting this on my birthday. So happy birthday to you for watching. Or is it happy birthday to me for filming? Thank you anyway. Okay, guys, well, I'm gonna get out of here because it's super cold. I really appreciate you guys tuning in, man. Subscribe, like, do all that stuff. You know, keep me going. I appreciate you guys. Until next time, let's get out of here.